One of the most effective habits that you can build that will take your personal knowledge management to the next level is finding connections between your ideas. And one of the best ways to find connections between your ideas is with bidirectional linking. So in this video, we're going to discuss what bidirectional linking is, how it works, how it helps me to find ideas that I've forgotten about, and also how I use it in my personal knowledge management system. Whether you've been using bidirectional linking for years or if you've never heard of it, I think you will enjoy this video. Now, before we dive into bidirectional linking, I do have a gift for you for watching this video and hanging out with me today. This is my free guide on how to take book notes and get those insights into your personal knowledge management system. So by the end of this guide, you will have a simple system for highlighting books, a mindful approach to adding content to your second brain, a process for creating building blocks of knowledge for the future, and then a simple way to make more connections in your personal knowledge management system. The link to that free guide is in the description below. All right, so if we break it down, a bidirectional link is simply a link that functions in two directions. Bidirectional. Now, this is different from hyperlinks. Those are all over the internet that you see, right? A hyperlink is in one direction. For example, if I click on a link within Wikipedia on a page, it's going to take me to another page, but I can't easily see that it's connected to the page that I was just on. So it's taking me in one direction and then another direction if I click on another link. Bidirectional links, on the other hand, you can see the connections. You can see how they're related to each other by outgoing links and then backlinks. We'll get into that in a second. So essentially, bidirectional links create doorways between your notes, meaning I can access both notes from each other. What's really powerful about bidirectional links is that it enables you to see multiple pathways of connection. Let me break that down for a second. Let's say that I'm reading a new book and come across an idea that I want to write down. So I create a new note. Let's call it note A, just for simplicity's sake. Now, as I'm thinking about note A, I realize that it relates really well and connects really well with note B. So I want to connect these notes in my personal knowledge management system. So while on note A, I am going to link to note B. Now, this is an outgoing link from note A to note B, like we talked about. Now, when I click into note B, I can not only see the link from note A, but also links from other notes that I've attached or connected to note B. What does this mean? It means that I can see related notes to note B that may be related and connect with note A. Now, some of these notes that I've created, I may have forgotten about, which is super cool. I didn't realize, oh man, I connected this note to note B, and now I realize this actually connects with note A, and it refines the idea that I had when reading the book, and I started to write down note A. So for example, maybe I read the title of note C, that is a backlink in note B, and I think, man, this is related, or this connects really well and complements this idea that I have in note A. So I want to connect those as well. So I go back into note A and link note C. It's an outgoing link to note C. And then when I go to note C, I'll see note A as a backlink in note C. And then in note C, there could be more backlinks on that may be related to note A or note B, whatever those other ideas are. You see what I'm saying is that there's multiple pathways of connection and ways to find ideas that you've forgotten about that really resonate and complement the ideas that you've been thinking about now. Okay, so I've shown you enough of the visuals here. What does it actually look like in my personal knowledge management system? I use Craft, by the way. If you've not seen my videos before, Craft Docs is my go-to note-taking app, and I absolutely love it. I love the simplicity. I love that it's fast, and it is my favorite note-taking app. Now, to link notes in Craft, it's very simple. So while on a note, I can type the at symbol, and it'll open up a search box for me to start typing the note that I want to link to, right? And so when I search, Craft is searching in a few different places. It searches the documents, it searches pages, which are basically documents within a page or a page within a document. It searches blocks within a page, so single lines of text. The Craft Docs note-taking app is a block-based note-taking app. It will search individual blocks, which is amazing. So it's not only can I drill down to the title of the page, but maybe there's something specific inside of the note that I'm thinking, man, this really relates to this specific sub idea of the main idea in the note. Really cool. And then it searches with matches within the document, right? So that's kind of like an anchor link kind of thing, where if I have a huge document or a huge note and there's something way down, a mile down below that I want to link to, I can link something within the document. When I click on it, it'll take me, scroll me down to that, or scroll me up, whatever direction. All right. So now I select the note. Once I find the note that I'm searching, I select the note and it will create an outgoing link to the other note. Now, when I click on this link that I just created, it takes me to the note that I've linked to. And here I can see the note contents. I can see the backlinks. I think it's actually links to this page instead of labeled backlinks, but it's links to this page at the bottom of the document. And I can see previews of all of the links without having to click in them. If I just hover over it, I can see the note contents and figure out, does this relate, without having to actually go into every single note, which is nice. For me, I usually am linking to three different types of notes. I've gone over this before in other videos, but I link to hubs, which are areas of my life or thought themes. And then we have projects. These are, for me, ideas that I'm heavily focused on, that I'm heavily thinking about. And then I have YouTube scripts, like for this video, for these videos, and books that I'm reading. I will make those projects. Helps me to kind of complete them and finish them. And then we have related notes. I want to show you a few examples in my personal knowledge management system of notes that have hubs related to them, projects and related notes. One of them is forget the fleeting and focus on the perennial. I click into it here. This is going to be a note that I took from reading the book Rework, or rereading it really. I'm starting to go through this book again and realizing there is a bunch of awesome stuff in here. But this particular note, I realized, has a lot to do with a project that I'm currently working on, which is my first online course. And then I have these hubs that are related. Building a product, Rework is the book, and I consider that a hub. Family, health, creativity, these are areas of my life that I feel like forget the fleeting and focus on the perennial. This is talking about products, but I feel like this is something that can apply to my marriage. This is something that can apply to me for as a parent, to not get caught up in the fleeting things, but to focus on the things that last. Let's jump back. And then we have, there's another one, the Gordon Ramsay method. Trim, then polish is what I've titled this note. Again, this is from the book Rework, and I have a bunch of hubs for this. This is, UX design, creativity, building a product, some of these other hubs you've already seen. And let's take a look at be a curator. Again, from the book Rework, if you've not read the book, actually it's a really good book to read. And I've got these notes here. I've taken, pictures of the pages where they are, started looking at what definition of curator and similar and opposite words. But then I have these related notes here. This is an example right here. If I hover over this, I've built my own private museum. Now, this is actually a block within a document right now that I'm able to link directly to. So as you can see there, I'm heavily thinking about online courses and how to build one that is going to be effective and all that. So those are some examples of notes that I've taken. Hey, thank you so much for hanging out with me today. I hope you found this useful. If you want to continue nerding out with me on all things personal knowledge management, then watch this next video.